Hello students, now we are moving towards the paper number May-June 2016, Zone 3. It carries 75 marks, 1 hour 45 minutes. First of all, I should explain some tips to prepare paper 3 or A-level mathematics. You should remember that each paper 3 and paper 1 carries 75 marks. If you have strong grip on paper 3, then it will very easy to perform in paper 1. So you should prepare 1 question, 2 question, 3 question a day. I mean minimum 5 marks a day. It's very easy for you. If you prepare 3 question a day, then it will be 30 times 90 questions in a month. If you continue this process whole the month without any gap, daily 3 questions, 15 marks, then you will prepare the paper 1 and paper 3 in maximum 2 or 3 months. Okay, now you should focus on paper 3 and learn the identities of trigonometries and some other useful functions or useful formulas. Then it will be very easy to solve paper number 3. Question 1 is related to the inequality. It is same in all the years. A little bit change in question number 1. Carry 4 marks. So in question number 1, first of all we should expand the inequality. Here I use very simple method of modulus extreme values. So you should also solve this question by using square on both sides and find the value of x. I expand first 2x, 2 into x minus 2 is equal to 3x plus 1, and 2 into x minus 1 is equal to minus 3x minus 1. It means I take one positive value or one negative values for modulus or extreme values. When I solve this equation, I find that x is equal to minus 5 and x is equal to 3 by 5. These are called critical values. Now we should check that our solution lies between these two values or away from these two values. First, I check that x is equal to minus 5, but I put the greater value minus 4 here. I find that the solution for minus 4, x is equal to minus 4, is true. So it means our value lies x is greater than minus 5, because here the solution is true. Again, I put x is equal to 1, the greater value x is equal to 3 by 5, the 1 is greater than 3 by 5. So I find that our area is false in x is equal to 1. So it means our solution is x is less than 3 by 5. So finally, I find that x is greater than minus 5 but less than 3 by 5. In question number 2, it's a logarithmic question. By taking logarithm shows that the graph of y against x is a straight line. You know that in O level that the equation of straight line, it means linear equation, the graph of linear equation is always a straight line. So we should reduce the powers in linear form. Taking ln on both sides, the rule, or we should apply the rule of logarithm here. The power should be in the front of the ln. So it will become ly ln of 3 is equal to 2 minus x ln of 4. This is a linear equation. This because I reduce the power by using logarithm. So it means the graph of linear equation is straight line. So this proves that which is required in part 1, that the equation of linear is a straight line. So y is equal to ln of 4 over ln of 3 into 2 minus x. In second statement, he is asking about the state the exact value of the gradient of this line. We should derivation of y is dy over dx, write ln of 4 over ln of 3 as it is, because this is a constant. Here he is behaving like a constant. The derivation of 2 is 0 and derivation of x is minus 1. So finally it will become dy over dx is equal to minus ln 4 over ln 3. Don't use calculator here. He is asking about the exact value. So exact value is minus ln 4 over ln 3. In second part, calculate the x coordinates of the point of intersection of this line with the line which with equation y is equal to 2x. Simplify your answer. Here we apply that y is equal to ln of 4 over ln of 3 into 2 minus x, and the other equation which is a other straight line with equation y is equal to 2x. I compare these two equations, and 2x is equal to ln of 4 over ln of 3 into 2 minus x. Hence, I simplify that 2x ln of 3 is equal to 2 into ln of 4 minus x into ln of 4. I take ln of one side, x values, 2x ln of 3 plus x ln of 4 is equal to ln of 4. I take common x, 2 ln of 3 plus ln of 4 is equal to ln of 4. In previous part, I reduce the power in front of the logarithm. Here, I put the power on 4 power 2 and 3 power 2 here. In logarithmic, the sum should be written in the product form. So x is equal to ln of 16, mean ln of 4 power 2 is ln of 16, and ln of 3 power 2 is 9, and write the ln of 4 as a product. So ln of 16 over ln 9 into 4, it will become ln of 4 over ln of 9. In question number 3, it's a trigonometric part. You should learn first of all trigonometric properties, then it will become very easy for you, otherwise it gives you a tough time. Express under root 5 cos x plus 2 sin x in the form of r cos x minus alpha. R is greater than 0, it means r is positive, and alpha is 0 to 90, it means the angle lies in the first quadrant only. So r cos x minus alpha, here I use the compound angle identity. When I expand by using compound angle identity, cos x minus alpha, it will become r cos x cos alpha plus r sin x sin alpha. So equating these two values, under root 5 is equated with r cos alpha, and cos x is equated with cos x. So r cos alpha is equal to under root 5. In the same way, r sin alpha is equal to 2. Squaring 1 and 2 and adding, I get that r square sin square alpha plus cos square alpha is equal to 9, because under root 5 is 5 and square of 2 is 4. 4 plus 5, 9. Here I use identity, sin square alpha plus cos square alpha is equal to 1. So r square into 1 will become r square. When taking square root on both sides, r is equal to 3. Only take positive value, because he has mentioned in the question where r is greater than 0. So only take positive value. Then dividing equation number 1 by 2, equation number 2 by 1. So tan alpha is equal to 2 over under root 5. Alpha is equal to tan inverse of this, and alpha is equal to 41.80. In part second, hence solve the equation under root 5 cos 1 by 2x and sin plus 2 sin 1 by 2x is equal to 1 by 2. Here he places x with 1 by 2x. It means angle he reduced to half. So if the limit for x is from 0 to 360, here is a half angle. So we divide these two limits by 2. We find that x over 2 is greater than 0 and less than 180, because 360 when it divided by 2, it will become 180. So our range is from 0 to 180. It means first and second quadrants only, not the 2 and third quadrant. So under root 5 cos x plus 2 under 2 sin x, we have already proved in part 1 that it is equal to 3 cos x minus 41.8. it means r cos x minus alpha. We find the value for and x in alpha in previous part. Here I used it. So 3 cos x over 2 minus 41.8 is equal to 1 by 2. Here I find that x over 2 minus 41.8 is equal to 66.4. The cos is positive in first and fourth quadrant. So because our range is from 0 to 180, it means angle lies in first and second quadrant. So don't take other values, only take first quadrant value, 66.4 here. So x over 2 is equal to 66.4 plus 41.8, it will become 108.2. when multiplied by 2, it will become 216.4 only. In question number 4, the parametric equations of a curve are x is equal to t plus cos t, y is equal to ln of 1 plus sin t. Parametric means take parameters, x and y are variables, t behaving like a parameters. रेंज इज फ्रॉम पाई बाय टू टू माइनस पाई बाय टू. सो डी वाई ओवर डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू सीकेंट टी वी शुड प्रूव हियर बाय टेकिंग डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एक्स डी एक्स ओवर डी टी. द डेरिवेशन ऑफ टी इज वन एंड डेरिवेशन ऑफ कॉस टी इज माइनस साइन टी. ऑन द अदर साइड डी वाई ओवर डी टी इज इक्वल टू द डेरिवेशन ऑफ एल एन इज वन ओवर वन प्लस साइन टी एंड डेरिवेशन ऑफ वन इज जीरो एंड डेरिवेशन ऑफ साइन टी इज कॉस टी. By using chain rule here, because we prove that dy dx is equal to secant t, here I use dy over dx chain rule, dy over dt multiply by dt over dx, I reciprocal the dx over dt. Cos t over 1 plus sin t, the value of dy over dt and value of dt over dx 1 over 1 minus sin t. So cos t over 1 minus sin square t, again I use the identity 1 minus sin square t is equal to cos t. So cos t over cos square t, it will become secant t because cos is cancelled with cos square. So 1 over cos t is equal to secant t. And second part, he is asking that, hence find the x coordinates of the point on the curve at which the gradient is equal to 3. Here I should put the gradient dy dx is equal to 3, 3 is equal to secant t. Here I again use the property of trigonometric ratios, trigonometric identity. 3 is equal to 1 over cos t is equal to 1 over 3, t is equal to cos inverse 1 over 3, t is equal to 1.23 here. I put this value in equation number x is equal to t plus cos t and y is equal to ln of 1 plus sin t. Don't need to put in y because only he is asking about the x coordinate. I put here x is equal to 1.23 plus cos 1.23, it will become x is equal to 1.57. Again, I put the negative value of x is equal to minus 1.23 plus cos of 1.23, it will become minus because the value inside the cos will become positive. So, it minus 0.896 here. The variable x and y satisfy the differential equation dy over dx is equal to e power minus 2y tan square x, and it is given that y is equal to 0 when x is equal to 0. Solve the differential equation and calculate the value of y when x is equal to pi by 4. In differential equation, I should strongly recommend it that first of all you should separate the variables x and y. Take variable y on left hand side and the variable x on right hand side. So dy over e power minus 2y is equal to tan square x dx. Here I use the identity of 1 plus tan square x is equal to secant square x because the integration secant square is tan x. So it will become very easy to integrate here. Taking integration on both sides, I took the e power minus 2y when in the denominator and numerator form, so it will become positive. So e power 2y dy is equal to secant square x minus 1 dx. When I integrate e power 2y, the integration e power 2y is e power 2y. When I integrate 2y, so it will become 1 over 2 because derivation of 2y is 2 and integration is inverse of derivation, so it will become 1 by 2 here. The integration of secant square x tan x because the derivation of tan x is equal to secant square derivation. Integration is the inverse of derivation. And the integration of x is 1 is minus x plus constant. And in order to find the value of c, I put the value of x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. I find that c is equal to 1 by 2. I place the value of c in the upper equation. 1 over 2 e power 2 y is equal to tan x minus x plus 1 by 2. So ln of e is equal to 1. So ln of e power 2y is equal to ln of 2 tan x minus 2x plus 1 here. I take ln of both sides. So when I should replace the power in front of ln, then ln of e will become 1. So ln of e power 2y is 2y only. Is equal to ln of 2 tan. I place the value pi by 4 here in the variable x. I will find that y is equal to 0.179. In question number 6, the curve with equation y is equal to x square cos 1 by 2x at stationary point at x is equal to p in the interval x 0 to pi. Show that p satisfy the equation tan p by 2 is equal to 4 by p. Here I derivate the equation by using product rule here. Dy over dx is equal to the derivation of x square is 2x and write cos 1 by 2x as it is, plus write x square as it is and take the derivation of cos 1 by 2x which is minus sin x 1 by 2x, then derivate 1 by 2x which is 1 by 2. The dy over dx at stationary point, turning point, minimum point, maximum point will always be 0. So dy dx is equal to 0, put 0 is equal to and dividing by cos 1 by 2x in order to take the requirement tan form. So 2x cos 1 by 2x is cancelled out by tan 1 by 2x, and when minus sin x 1 by 2x it will become tan 1 by 2x. So x square 2x minus x square over 2 tan 1 by 2x. When I simplify this, I find that tan 1 by 2 is equal to 2 into 2p over p square is equal to 4 over p. So tan 1 by 2p is equal to 4 over p, which is the required. In part 2, verify by calculation that p lies between 2 and 2.5. From the previous question, when I take the standard form of previous equation, then it will become tan 1 by 2p minus 4 by p is equal to 0. Here I apply the value 2 and 2.5. When I put 2, so it is the solution is less than 0, it means in negative form. When I apply 2.5, the solution is greater than 0, it means positive. So when there is a change of sign between these two values, it means the root is lies between 2 and 2.5. In third part, use the iterative formula Pn plus 1 2 tan inverse 4 over Pn to determine the value of P correct to 2 decimal places. It means our final solution should be 2 decimal places. Give the result of each iteration to 4 decimal places. It means we should answer the each iteration by 4 decimal places. So first of all, I find P1 is equal to from previous part that our solution is lies between 2 and 2.5. I suppose that solution is lies in the middle. 2 plus 2.5 over 2 is equal to 2.25. I place this value in the variable P. So P2 is equal to 10 inverse 4 over 2.5. It will become this 2.1168. In this way, then I put the value of P2 and find the P3, then value of P3, putting in next equation, find the value of P4, then P5, then P6. I find that the root is repeating from 2.1559 and 2.1529. So answer is 2.15 here. In question number 7, it's an integration part. Integration I is equal to this dx using the substitution method. The substitution and the by parts methods is the most difficult part of the integration. So you should have full focus on this question. Show that I is equal to 1 limit 2 to 1 u minus 1 whole square over 2 u cube 3 months. First I find the limits. So 1 plus x square is equal to u. First I put the value of x is 0. Then I find u is equal to 1. Then I put the value of x is equal to 1. I find that u is equal to 2 here. Then I derivate 1 plus x square is equal to u. The derivation of 1 is 0. X square 2x dx and u du. I find that x dx is equal to du over 2. And x square is equal to u minus 1 from 1 plus x square equal to u. And x4 is taking square on both sides. X square is equal to u minus 1 whole square. I separate the equation x5, the variable x5 into x4 into x dx because I have find that x dx is equal to du over 2. So I place the value of x4, x dx and 1 plus x square whole cube here. I find finally that u minus 1 whole square du over 2 into u cube. Hence, find the exact value of I. I find that I is equal to u minus 1 whole square over 2 u cube. When I split the previous part, I find that u square over expand the square u minus 1 whole square here. So u square over u cube minus 2 u over u cube plus 1 over u cube. So I find that वन ओवर यू माइनस टू यू पावर माइनस टू प्लस यू पावर माइनस थ्री वेन ए अप्लाइड द रूल ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वन ओवर एक्स इज एल एन ऑफ एक्स सो इंटीग्रेशन वन ओवर यू इज एल एन ऑफ यू हेयर इन सेकेंड आई यूज द पावर रूल पावर इज वन इज एडेड सो माइनस टू प्लस वन विल बिकम माइनस वन एंड डिवाइडेड बाई माइनस वन इट विल बिकम टू ओवर यू माइनस वन ओवर टू यू स्केयर बिकॉज वेन आई हैव एडेड माइनस थ्री प्लस वन द पावर विल बिकम माइनस टू एंड देन डिवाइडेड बाई द पावर माइनस टू सो इट विल बिकम वन ओवर टू यू स्केयर देन अप्लाइड द अपर लिमिट लोअर लिमिट द रूल इज दैट फर्स्ट यू शुड अप्लाई द अपर लिमिट देन टेक अ नेगेटिव साइन एंड देन पुट अ लोअर लिमिट एंड फाइंड द फाइनल आंसर सो फाइनल आंसर इज वन बाय टू एल एन एफ टू माइनस फाइव बाय सिक्सटीन In question number 8, it's a vectors equation. The point A, B, A and B, I have the position vectors relative to the origin OA, this, OB, this and line L has equation this. Show that the line passing through A and B does not intersect. This part of the vector is related to the line's equation. So, he is asking about that you should prove that the line starts does not intersect. It means when we take general points of both lines, one line is L and another line we should find AB. So first I find that AB is equal to direction of AB. OB minus OA, it is 1 minus 1, 2. Then equation of line AB, take 1 point, 1, 1 and 1 plus lambda. Take the direction I minus j plus 2k. A second, the equation of L is also given. It is this. By equating the general points of both lines, the general points of the equation of line AB will become 1 plus lambda, 1 minus lambda, 1 plus 2 lambda. So 1 plus lambda is equating with 2 minus mu. And then minus 2 plus 2 mu and then so equate the general points here first of all we should take the general points here I have missing these two points you should find by yourself the general point of line AB is 1 plus lambda into I phir 1 minus lambda into j phir next 1 plus 2 lambda into k and the general point of L is 2 minus mu into I minus 2 plus 2 mu into j minus 1 plus mu into k then equate the these two general points I will first of all I will solve the equation 1 and 2 simultaneously I find that u mu is equal to 2 then find the value of lambda is equal to z minus 1 then I put these two values in equation number 3 If they are intersecting, then right hand should be equal to left hand side. If right and left side sides are not equal, it means that the equation do not intersecting each other. So left and right side not equal, though it means equation do not intersecting here. In equation part 2, show that the length of the perpendicular from A to L, it means point A to line L. Here is a point A and line L. The perpendicular distance between point A to line L is 1 over root 2 we should prove. Or the equation of line L is this equation of line L. General point, I first of all I take general point, any point should be here. General point of line L is P is equal to, I name this point P. So general point is equal to 2 minus mu minus 2 plus 2 mu minus 1 plus mu here. PA. Now I find the direction PA, the direction from point A to general point P. So PA is equal to OA minus OP. It will become minus 1 plus mu, 3 minus 2 mu, 2 minus mu. Product of PA and L, direction equal to 0. Because the direction of line and direction of PA cut each other at right angle, perpendicular, these two lines are perpendicular. So the dot product of two perpendicular lines should be zero. So the direction of PA dot direction of line L, which is minus 1, 2 and 1. I use a product rule here, dot product. I find that mu is equal to 3 by 2. Then I put mu in द पॉइंट पी इज इक्वल हियर विच इज टू माइनस म्यू माइनस टू प्लस टू म्यू माइनस वन प्लस टू म्यू आई फाइंड दैट पी ए इज इक्वल टू वन बाई टू जीरो वन बाई टू सो पी ए टेकिंग द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ पी ए द स्क्वेयर ऑफ वन बाई टू वन बाई फोर द स्क्वेयर ऑफ जीरो इज जीरो एंड देन स्क्वेयर इज वन बाई टू इज वन बाई फोर आई फाइनली फाइंड दैट पी ए परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस इक्वल टू वन ओवर टू अंडर रूट. Now move towards the question number 9. Throughout this question calculator is not permitted here. The complex number 1 plus 3 yota, 2 minus yota are denoted by u and v respectively in Argand diagram with origin. The point A, B, C is represented the number u, v and u plus v respectively. Sketch the diagram state fully the geometrical relationship between O, B and AC. U is equal to minus 1 plus 3 yota, V is equal to 2 minus yota, U plus V is equal to adding these two vectors, I find that 1 plus 2i. So OB magnitude is equal to under root 5. AC is equal to OC minus OA. So I find that AC is equal to 2 minus yota. So AC magnitude will become under root 5. Because AC is equal to U plus V, U plus V. So I find that U plus V is this. So then AC magnitude of AC also under root 5. It means if these two vectors have equal magnitude, then they are equal in magnitude. When I draw these three vectors O, B, O, C and AC and OA. So I find that OBCA it's a parallelogram. So these two vectors are parallel and AC and OB are parallel and equal here. In part 2, find in terms of x plus yota y where x and y are real the complex number u over v. Here it's a very simple part. So I put the value of u and v and then rationalize it to plus yota over 2 plus yota, yota square is equal to minus 1. I find that it is equal to minus 1 plus iota. Here not 1, it's a iota, minus 1 plus iota. Prove that angle AOB is equal to 3 pi by 4. From the previous figure, we find that AOB angle is equal to argument of u over v. So argument of u over v is equal to tan inverse of 1. I use only 1 because it's a minus 1, not a 1. So first of all, I find the basic angle or principal angle, which is equal to pi by 4. Then it means AOB lies in the second quadrant. Then I find the angle AOB is equal to pi minus pi by 4 because minus 1 is value of x, which is negative in second quadrant. And value of imaginary part iota is plus 1, which is a positive. So x is negative in second quadrant and y is positive in second quadrant. So it means angle lies in the second quadrant. So angle is equal to pi minus pi by 4 is equal to 3 pi by 4, which is a required angle. In question number 10, it is related to the partial fraction. Express 10x minus 2x square over x plus 1 into x minus 1 whole square in the partial fraction form. 10x over minus 2x square over x plus 1, x minus 1 whole square is equal to a over x plus 3. Here it's not x plus 1, it's a x plus 3. By mistake here I write 1, it's a x plus 3. So a over x plus 3 plus b over x minus 1 plus c over x minus 1 whole square. I treat this raising power as a linear here because it's very easy. So I multiplied x plus 3 x minus 1 whole square on both sides. I find that 10x minus 2x square is equal to a into x minus 1 whole square plus b into x plus 3 x minus 1 plus c into x plus 3. First of all, I take that x is equal to minus 3. I find that a is equal to minus 3 by putting the value of x is equal to minus 3. Then I suppose that x is equal to 1. I put the value of x 1. Then I find that c is equal to 2. Similarly, in third place, I suppose that x is equal to 0. You can take any value of x. I should place x is equal to 0, which is very easy to solve. So when I put x is equal to 0, I find that b is equal to 1. Then the final partial form is minus 3 over x plus 3 plus 1 over x minus 1 plus 2 over x plus x minus 1 whole. In second part, hence obtain the expression of fx in ascending power of x up to including the term x square. It means we should use the binomial theorem until the power x square here. From the previous part, I find that minus 3 over x plus 3 plus 1 over x minus 1 plus 1 over 2 over x minus 1 whole square by using binomial expansion here. Binomial expansion, first condition is that the first is constant 1, then take any sign, and then other is a variable power n. Then we applied the binomial expansion, otherwise it's not possible to apply the binomial expansion. So I take 3 common from first equation, it will become 3 1 minus x over 3. Then take minus 1 common in the x minus 1, then take minus 1 square common in x minus 1 whole square. So it finally become minus 1 minus x over 3 whole power minus 1 minus 1 minus x power minus 1 and 2 into 1 minus x power minus 2. When I applied the formula 1 plus nx, I find that 1 plus nx plus n into n minus 1 x square over 2 factorial. Similarly, and applied the second term, I find that 1 plus nx into plus n into n minus 1 x square over 2 factorial, and in the third equation. Then I finally find that by simplifying that 10 over 3x plus 44 over 9x square is the required answer of this.